Today is about fashion and it's about freedom. Concealed carry isn't a luxury, it is a necessity.
The Women's Concealed Carry Fashion Show event started with an idea to educate the women on different ways to carry. It started in the living room of my home, and the interest was so great. Here we are the second time with over 450 people.
They were packed in there like sardines, which was a wonderful problem to have. It shows that there's a demand for this kind of information, this kind of education, and this kind of experience.
I modeled an ankle holster. It holds any medium-sized pistol or revolver. It's very comfortable. I could wear this all day long.
Women are the fastest growing segment of the shooting sports, and right now women are the most important aspect of the Second Amendment fight, and they're coming out in large numbers to support us.
I have definitely seen more women getting involved in the fight for the Second Amendment and getting active, and I see that happening in a huge way. A lot of my close friends are expressing interest in getting their pistol permits.
There's just so many attacks, especially here in New York. We've got the SAFE Act now, but women are coming into their own. They're understanding that when we're told that we can only have 7 rounds in a magazine and criminals can have 10, they're gonna sit up and take notice and say, I don't think so.
Women are absolutely buying more firearms. Women are looking for training. Women are looking for the sport of shooting, and they want to own their own. They want to protect themselves. They want to protect their families.
My handgun permit and the right to carry is my equalizer.
Whether it's a mother, whether it's a nurse, we want to make them aware that they can be safe in any given situation and be comfortable wearing a gun and carrying a gun.
It's about true empowerment, which is being responsible for our own safety and our own security. I live in a rural community, and if someone does try to break into your home or your car, I don't have minutes, you may have seconds.
When you come to an event like this, what I see is average, good Americans who love their family, love their country. Many are servicemen who've served in the military. That's America.
And also, it's a community. It's a community of people who have the same belief in the Second Amendment right and protecting that right, and also protecting women and being safe.
I do see a threat to our right to keep and bear arms today. A lot of people speaking things that are not true. There's many people in America who have used their God-given right to keep and bear arms to defend themselves and protect their homes, and those things are not put on the news. The good news is often hidden.
Absolutely, in New York State it is being threatened. However, we as women have a great voice. We are a powerful group of people who can stand up right alongside men, and there's power in numbers.
Every vote counts, every voice counts, and as women, as gun owners, we can do this, and nothing is gonna stop us.
When a legislator gets a phone call from a woman about firearms issues, and the more women that show up in the offices of legislators at all levels of government, they will indeed see, take notice and say that women voters, women gun owner voters, are going to be a force to be reckoned with.
America without the right to keep and bear arms is gonna fall. I really am concerned for that right being taken away.
When I hear about gun control, when I hear about gun registration, I know our rights are not untouchable. They can be taken away from us. And it's our duty to protect them, preserve them for our own good, but for the better of the new generations.
It's my right, and I want to keep it, and I don't want anyone to take it away.